Hi everyone, welcome back to the sessions of Vocabs, and I'm Raki, your tutor for this particular session. So in this session, I'll tell you about some of the vocabs which can come in your competitive exams and as well as you can use them in your daily life. So without wasting a minute, let's get started with the first word of the session, and the word for all of you is wow. See, most of you would pronounce this particular word as woo, W-O-E. You would say it as woo, which is a wrong pronunciation. The correct pronunciation is wow, wow, W-O-E, wow. Clear? And the meaning for this particular word is great sorrow or distress, misery, unhappiness. Clear? That means a person who is passing through a phase of great unhappiness, great tension, great sorrow and great misery. That means nothing is going good in the life of that particular person. He is having so much of sorrow and tension in his or her life. Clear? For example, please listen very carefully. Her face was lined and full of wow. Her face was lined and full of wow. Fine. So again, it is not woo, it is wow. Clear? The next word for you, paragon. Paragon means a model of excellence, or we can say good example. A model of excellence or good example. That means a person who is idol to someone. A person who sets good example in the society. Clear? For example, a model of punctuality. A model of punctuality, Mona is never late for the event. That means Mona is actually a good example who, or I should say, Mona is very, very punctual. It means Mona is really very punctual and she had set a good example regarding punctuality. She never gets late for any event. Clear? So, the person who sets good example in the society, and the short word used for them is paragon. So, Mona is paragon of punctuality. Clear? The next one. Ruminate. Ruminate means to think deeply about something. That means you actually are considering something. You have actually the consideration of that particular thing. You consider that thing. That's why you are thinking deeply for that thing. Clear? So, to think deeply about something, to consider that particular thing very much, and you think very much deep into that. Clear? For example, as people grow older, they begin to ruminate on the uncertainty of life. Clear? Now, Many weeks have passed on ruminating about whether I should tell him or not. Many weeks have passed ruminating whether I should tell him or not. Fine. That means you are thinking very much deeply. You are actually considering something and it has taken you long weeks to tell him, to decide whether to tell him or not. Clear? So, in a nutshell, to think very deeply, to consider some point in very deep. Clear? The next one, kindle. Kindle means set something on fire, or we can say arouse or inspire. Now over here, my friends, kindle has two meanings. The first meaning is as it is, which is in front of you. That means set something on fire. From this particular sentence, from this particular phrase, what actually you are getting? You are actually thinking that we can set something on fire. You can set a wood on fire. You can set a bonfire. Fine. A kind of, that means you can set wood on fire. That means you can actually burn something. So set something on fire means to burn something. Fine. So first meaning is clear to you. The second meaning is that to cause strong feelings or ideas in someone. The first meaning is to set something on fire. That means to burn something. Second meaning for kindle is, listen very carefully, to cause strong feelings or ideas in someone. And those feelings could be harsh or hard feelings, or on the other hand, those feelings could be soft or lovable feelings. Clear? So these were the two meanings of kindle. Now the sentence I can make from the first meaning is, this wood is too wet to kindle. This wood is too wet to kindle. Clear? And the next meaning is a warm feelings started to kindle inside her. A warm feelings for him started to kindle inside her. So I think the meaning in the sentences is now clear to all of you regarding the word kindle. Don't forget it. The last word of the session, callous. Callous means insensitive or cruel. That means a person who is really hard-hearted, who actually do not have any feelings or any emotions for anyone or anybody. Clear? A person who is emotionless. Fine. A person who is very, very cruel. Fine. Now, the sentence is, a man who stole from the poor. A man who stole from the poor was a callous thief. Right? So, if somebody is stealing something from a poor person, obviously that person does not possess heart, I should say. That person is heartless. Fine. So, callous means a person who is very cruel, who is hard-hearted, who is emotionless. So, I repeat the sentence again. A man who stole from the poor was a callous thief. Okay. So, I think this particular session is very much clear to all of you, and you wouldn't forget whatever I have said you regarding the meanings of these particular sentences, and you will use them in a nice way. So, this was all about this particular session, and I'm Rakhi saying you all now goodbye and take care.